My name is Leon Wierenka. Today I will be talking about a new option available for VSA called Direct Data Connectivity. Let's get started. Up until now, there has been two methods to get IQ data into VSA for further analysis. The primary and most common is by connecting to hardware. There are over 200 KeySight model supported, so a customer can find the right hardware for their application. Secondly, VSA supports over half a dozen file formats that can be used to save and recall IQ data recordings. Now, a third method is via the direct data connectivity. This is for situations where the customer has waveform data. They can now directly send the data to VSA. These can be situations where the customer may have custom hardware that is not connected to VSA, may be running simulations, may have production data stored in a database, or have an application that performs signal processing on IQ data and wants to view and analyze this data with VSA. Whatever form this customer application is, they can now push IQ data directly to VSA through the Direct Data Connectivity.net API. Let's get into a few details with respect to the use of the .NET API to push the IQ data into VSA. From the graphic on the left-hand side, you can see the user application. It may have a GUI, it may have other APIs, but typically would have one API to bring the IQ data into memory. That's where the data provider comes in. Once the application has the IQ data, it's up to that application to fill out the data associated with the IQ data. This would include within the setup portion of the user input classes to be able to enter sample rate, center frequency, channel count, span, etc. There's other details, but these are the main points and the main pieces of information that are needed to be able to push the data. You'll note that typically when somebody is acquiring data from the hardware, it's the VSA that will query the hardware for these types of parameters, or they may be set from the VSA GUI. But in this case, the user application needs to know the details of the measurement or of the IQ data such that it is set up correctly in VSA. Once those parameters are set up, then the user input data class is used to actually push the data. So once the data is set up, the VSA will coerce the measurement and set up the measurement based on the parameters that were set and also based on the MES setup settings within the measurement itself. These will prioritize time, resolution, bandwidth, or FFT points, depending on how the user has set these up. There's feedback from VSA to the user application. This consists of information telling the application how many data points are needed to satisfy the VSA measurement setup, and also events when VSA has finished processing a block of data and when it's ready for another block. So this is the handshaking that allows a user application to stream either block data or stream data into the VSA on a continuous basis. Okay, let's cover the features associated with direct data connectivity. We've already touched base on the IQ data setup and the coercion that VSA does based on this data to fit the data in the measurement, and also touch base on the polling and event-driven model from the interface that supports the data transfer. The data can be non-contiguous or contiguous. Typically, hardware acquires data in block form and analyzes based on each block, where contiguous data feed may be a stream from a simulation or a situation where the user wants to capture all the demodulated symbols without gaps. again, the polling and event-driven models support both of these methods of data transfer. We support up to 8 input channels, and those channels can be complex IQ or baseband data. So whether you're working in the RF realm or baseband real data from oscilloscopes, etc., both are supported. To work with direct data connectivity, in addition to the actual direct data connectivity license, the minimum VSA version is 2022, update 1 or newer, since this is a new feature within VSA. And of course, the base VSA license is also needed. Okay, to help qualify customers that may benefit from direct data connectivity and to help engage with these customers to show the features, a number of resources have been prepared. A couple examples have been put together and are available as part of the VSA release. One is the console demo. This demonstrates the block-oriented data transfer mode that we talked about. And then there's also a WPF demo that goes into more detail with the streaming capability. There's also a technical overview. It goes more into the details of the customers that would find this feature useful, and also summarizes the capabilities of this option in more detail than we've gone through on the slide. There's also an application note. This is for solution engineers to learn more about direct data connectivity and for customers to help them implement the data transfer portion of their application. There's also a couple of demo guides as well. These don't go as much into details about the code as the application note does, but are basically just guidelines to be able to successfully walk through each one of the demos and demonstrate the capabilities that they offer. All of this data starts with the new landing page as well. The link there will get you to the option, the details, pricing information, and option numbers, etc., as well as linking a lot of these technical resources to the option. Thanks for your time. I hope you found this overview of direct data connectivity informative. For further information, follow the links to the resources that were provided, or if you have any further questions, feel free to contact me and I'll try to help answer your questions.